Hello everyone, in today's video we're going to take a look at how we can manage public websites inside the new knowledge management in Copilot Studio. So here you can see on my screen I'm showing you a Copilot that I created with some files that I've uploaded and one website that I want to use in my knowledge. But as an admin, I may want the other developers to only use specific websites that I decide from a governance perspective. Maybe I want to block some website, or maybe I want to only allow a short list of websites. So to do that, we're going to take a look at a new feature in the data loss policy configuration that is in preview today. So let me jump to my Power Platform Admin Center. In here, I'm going to scroll down to Policies and Data Policies. In here, I created a new data policy that I called Restricted Website. I'm going to edit that policy to show you what's in there. When you go to the pre-built connector, you will see three different categories: the business, non-business, and blocked. By default, all connectors are going to be non-business, and that is going to be the default group that all of your copilots are going to be using. You can change the default group by clicking on the Set Default Group button. For today's example, I'm going to leave the default group as non-business here, and I'm going to configure the public website knowledge source. So for that, I'm going to search for website. Here, you can see my knowledge source with public website, and it has an option that says configure connector endpoints, preview. I'm going to click on this. And here you can see that you can actually add websites or URLs with pattern matching character like star. And by default, you will have one rule that says it applies to all endpoints. And you cannot delete that rule. You can see the delete button is grayed out. But here I can add another endpoint and potentially multiple websites. So let's delete that one and show you how I did that. I clicked on add endpoint. I can select the order on which those different rules are going to be applied. And for each rule, I can allow or deny. So if, for example, I only want to allow a specific website, I could say I want to use only that apple.com website. But if I want none of my developers to use the apple.com domain and any subdomain from apple.com, I can do star apple.com and I could click on, I can select the option deny. I'm going to do like that. So in here, I'm going to save that configuration for my knowledge source with public website. In here, I'm going to click cancel because I don't want to change anything for now. I'm going to click next. Apply my DLP. So next, I can choose all environment, specific environment, or exclude some environment. For this demo, I'm just going to add all environment. And there you go. We can see here, we have our policy to review all environment. I'm going to update that policy. So note that when you create or when you create a policy or update a policy, it has to be enabled. DLP has to be enabled on your environment. And for that, you're doing, you need to use the Microsoft PowerShell. And there is a video from Dwayne Robinson on how to configure the Windows PowerShell to access your Power Platform tenant. I'm not gonna go into details about that, but here, I just wanna show you that I made sure that my tenant ID here has the policy enabled. Because if you don't have the DLP policy enabled, any change that you make into the Power Platform Admin Center is going to be ignored by your copilots. All right, let's jump back to our test copilot. And in the knowledge here, I'm going to try to add the apple.com public website. So here you're gonna see I'm going to add apple.com and I'm going to click add. And instead of being instant, it's going to take a few minutes because it's actually going to go through all the DLP that I've configured on my Copilot to make sure that is this website allowed. And you can see here, apple.com is blocked And it says not allowed due to your organization data loss prevention policies. And you can see here it's preventing you from publishing your Copilot. So it says unless you fix that, you won't be able to publish your Copilot. So that works pretty well. All right, that's it for today. Thank you for watching.